Hey everybody, and welcome to episode, I think it's 134 of the Building a Law Firm podcast. I'm your host, Christopher Small, and we're trying something different here today, and hopefully you guys don't get mad at me, but we are on our way to work, and I figured I'd just kill two birds with one stone and get this going. So, you're going to watch me drive, and I'm going to talk, and hopefully you don't get too mad at me. It's sort of not exactly, it's kind of like listening to a podcast while I'm driving, because I'm just talking to you. So, you know, that's how we're going to do it. But anyway, before we even get into it, I want to remind you and I guess invite you to listen to the rest of this episode because it's going to give you kind of a sneak peek into what we're about to talk about. But I am hosting a live workshop on April 5th, 2019 in Kansas City. If you are not busy that day, I would love for you to come. We've got 25 spots. As of the recording of this episode, there are 18 spots left. I expect that to go to probably about 10 spots pretty quickly because I know some people that are about to sign up. But in any event, oh, my camera's over here. I keep looking over there. Anyway, but in any event, if you are interested or you want to just go learn more, please go to Q2Workshop.com. That's it. No building a law firm or anything, just Q2Workshop.com and check it out. I think you're going to be pleasantly surprised. And if you really want another sneak peek, just keep listening because that's what we're going to talk about today is basically what we're going to break down in that workshop over the course of a day because I can only cover so much in, you know, 20, 25 minutes that I'm driving to work. So get buckled up, get buckled in because we're going to dive in. All right. So what I want to talk about is a content strategy slash advertising strategy that has been doing really, really well for me. And I think it will be continue to do well as it grows and is the wave of the future. And if you're not on getting on the boat or on the train or whatever sort of mode of transportation that you, like, then you're going to miss out. Okay. And you're going to miss out big time and you're going to miss out in the type of way that, if you're an estate planning attorney, at least I could literally come into your town and take over. Okay. Not all the way, obviously, but take it for a lot. Okay. It's serious business. I'm kidding sort of, but anyway, what we're talking about here is sort of it's the next level. It's an iteration from what my old content strategy was. If you recall, to sort of back all the way up, when I started CMS Law Firm, sort of like 2.0, which is the estate planning, my estate planning law firm in 2016, I started that business by basically doing one, I really did two things. I got there and networked, met a bunch of people that, you know, were duds and a couple of good ones that sent me some business. And then I also was just generating content all the time. I did, to start that business out, I did a video a week for like 77 days, I think. I was going for 100, but I just got burned out. Business started coming in by that time, and so I ramped it down at that point to once a week. I've been doing this podcast for once a week forever, and you're here. And, you know, there's people in the back room. There's we're going to have to splice these videos together because hopefully that one at least saved. But anyway, people called, and the phone just turns off. So I should just put it into airplane mode. I don't know that I can. But anyway, I'll just cut these together. So what you saw there was somebody called me. And anyway, probably a darn marketer, right? So I was doing a video, like this podcast, you know, been doing a video a week forever. That's basically it. I haven't been doing a lot of really extra stuff. But recently, and by recently I mean the last probably 3 or 4 months, I have been studying, I guess, this methodology that's called intent-based branding. Frank Kern is the person that came up with this original idea, and I've been applying it to my law firm, and I've been applying it to building a law firm as well, and it's been working really, really, really well. And what I'm going to do is sort of break that down for you today. So to begin with, there are three sort of main pillars that go into intent-based branding, and they work for they work for building a law firm, but it's even easier for what we're trying to do. So the three pillars are create content consistently And that means like almost every day. Don't get scared yet. It means creating goodwill via that content, which really means helping people and caring about them, being yourself. And then it also means make an offer, which means don't forget to tell people like how they can work with you. Okay. It's a pretty simple formula and it works really, really well. So that's how you make the content. You literally turn the video camera on just like I'm doing right now. You start talking. These are done though via Facebook Live. Okay. So we go live, we do them. You don't have to go live, I guess, but, they're more fun when you go live because people show up and they interact with you and they like you and that's good. And so when anybody interacts with your with your posts or likes your posts, then Facebook wants to get more of that, and so they send it out into the world. So you get organic reach, you get to meet new people, you get to meet new clients. It's all fun and dandy, right? It's all good. It's all gravy, as they say. So that is sort of step one. It's really you're just creating good content every day. And this content needs to be between like 5 and 10 minutes long. Oh, I told you it's going to be easier for us. It is. Because basically what you want to think about is where are your ideal clients at and where do they want to go? And for the most part, and so Frank Kern's example is ain't got no money, want to get mo' money, right? And that's where you all are. That's where I'm at with my business. That's why his methodology appeals to me. That's why this appeals to you probably. And for our potential clients, it's really, I have a problem, right? Which it could be for me, it would be like, ain't got no estate plan, right? And the solution that they want is, I need an estate plan, okay? And the pillars in between there might be like, I need to learn about what I need, which will be content, right? I need to learn about what I need, and I need to learn about who can do it for me, right? So how do I pick a good attorney? And for those, and that right there gives you the things that you need to talk about. So for example, yesterday I did a Facebook Live on 5 signs that you have a shady estate planning attorney. And today I'm going to do, I think, how to pick a guardian. You know, like if you can't agree with your spouse or something. I've done that a couple times. But that's the other thing too. You can talk about this stuff over and over again and just reiterate your concepts. And as you do this on the daily, and as more and more people see it, it A, begins to get you more clients, right? Because the people that are watching these kinds of videos are the kind of people that are interested in hiring. Another phone call. Who are these people? I usually get 0 calls on the way to the office. I already have 2. But B, what was I going to say? You get to build brand, right? So A is they call you. 2 is you get to build up a brand because people are going to just be seeing you in their feed all the time. And it's going to be amazing. And so eventually what happens is even if they don't need you right now, you become known as the person that's talking about estate planning or family law or criminal defense or anything like that, okay? All right, now, quick side note, because I know this is probably something that you're thinking about. It's something that I was thinking about too. So, you know, estate planning is important but not urgent, okay? So I thought that this Facebook strategy would be really good for estate planning because you have the time to kind of warm up to people. They can see your content, you can teach them and sort of create some sense of urgency with your content, and that's great. But I wasn't so sure about the important but urgent practice areas because I thought to myself, you know, if somebody is looking for like a criminal defense attorney, for example, they're not really turning to Facebook to find that information. If they need a personal injury attorney, they're not looking to Facebook to find that person. But, and I know this because I've talked to Frank about it. I was actually at a live workshop with him on Friday and got to ask him these questions specifically. And I also saw other attendees. I talked to some of the people that were there that their businesses fall into the same important but urgent sort of framework. And one of them actually was a lady that does power of attorney services. So she's not a lawyer. But she actually, when people need a power of attorney, like to act for someone, like a guardian, basically, court-appointed guardian, she's that person. And she's creating a business all around doing that. She's creating an informational product for people that find themselves named as agents, so they know what to do, and they don't mess up. But anyway, So this works with important but urgent matters as well. And the reason is because of the way that we are framing the messages that people are finding on Facebook, right? These aren't billboards splattered across the way saying, call me, call me, call me. Got an injury? Call me, call me. No, it's more like, you know, this is the number one tip to deal with insurance agents after a car accident. And so what happens is they're like, shit, I was just in a car accident. I want to know about this. I need to learn this. And so they listen. Okay. All right. So that's step one. That's like phase one. Okay. Strategy one of this whole methodology. And you could probably just stop there and get business off of this. Not only could you, you definitely can, because with these Facebook Lives, you can still also employ your Be Everywhere blueprint sort of strategy that I've, my Be Everywhere content strategy that I employ right now with these podcasts, which is when I'm done with this, you download the video, right? You record, you upload it to YouTube, you pull out the audio, you put the audio and create a podcast, an audio podcast, and then you put the video on LinkedIn. You can put it up on Instagram if you want, and if you have somebody that can chop it up for you, that's even better. They chop it up into like these little minute splices, and then they send it all over the internet for you, and then you win, right? It's even more, just more building, more brand building, more content out there for you. So you can continue to do these strategies with these Facebook Live videos, and I'm doing that. I have my paralegal is actually the one that does it. She's kind of interested in this stuff a little bit, so every day she downloads the Facebook video off of Facebook, uploads it to YouTube, and then as soon as I get around to showing her how to do it and like creating the process, we're going to create a new podcast. It's going to be the I'm not telling you what the name is, I guess, because it's a secret, but we're going to create this new podcast, and it's going to be amazing, and it's going to be all of my daily videos, right? So I'm not doing this Facebook Live right now. This is not live on Facebook. And I don't know if I'm going to share this to Facebook or not. I want to try to create some content that's separate from there for here, maybe. It doesn't matter, though, because you guys like it all everywhere. But that's phase one, or stage one, or strategy one. Seriously, the phone calls have got to stop. And they're all foreign calls. So I found myself on some foreign person's call list this morning. And they're just bugging me now. So anyway, that's stage one. Like I said, you can do that if you want. That's what I would call the organic strategy, okay? But the other thing that you can do is you can put paid money behind this too for very, very cheap and really go gangbusters. So right now my budget, by the way, just to get this right out of the way, because you're probably wondering like, oh, how much money do I have to spend? Oh, how do I do this? Blah, blah, blah. This sounds risky. I don't know. I'm spending $30 a day, okay? So I'm spending basically $1,000 a month, and my goal is to get 2 clients a month from this strategy right now at $30 a day, okay? Which will yield me at the very minimum, so even if I get 2 very basic estate planning clients, it will yield me $2,000 to $2,500, okay? Which is a 2-to-1 return on my ad spend at the very least. You know, I spend $1,000, I'm gonna make at least 2, all right? And the idea is, if that happens, I'm gonna turn that volume up to 40 bucks a day and then 50 bucks a day, and then I'm just gonna keep going until, you know, I don't know, until forever, right? So that is what we're talking about, $30 a day. You can go as low as probably like $10 a day if you really want to and still have an impact. It will take a little bit longer to have the kind of impact that we're gonna talk about, but it will happen. And you know, these are investments in your business, so I would try it. Got it. Okay. So phase two involves using Facebook ads. Okay. Basically, it's pretty straightforward. But the way that it works is Facebook allows you to track the amount of time that somebody watches your videos. And they'll break them up into 3-second chunks, 10-second chunks, 25%, 50, 75, and 95, and 100% chunks. Okay. And what you can do is you can tell Facebook how to put these people that watch these videos at these different lengths in different buckets if you want, all right? So what I do is this. I've created 4 or 5 what I think are like super good, legit videos, okay? These are the ones that everybody wants to watch. And They are my cold audience videos, okay? So after I've recorded these videos on Facebook Live, gosh, that's sunny. After I've recorded these videos on Facebook Live, I go into the ads platform and I tell Facebook, create a bucket of anybody that watches 10 seconds or more of any of these cold audience videos, okay? And then I send these videos out into the world to people that don't know me. So you would not ever get these videos because you know me. You have interacted on my website, you have liked my Facebook page, you're on my list, we've done something together, we've hung out, you know, we've said hello to each other. That would not get you, you would not be seeing these videos. You would still see the video, but just in a different way, which I'll tell you about in a second. So you start sending these out, you start filling up these buckets, okay? For me, it's a 10 second bucket. Anybody watches a video for 10 seconds, they get put into a different bucket that I'm calling the warm audience. You would be included into the warm audience, okay? The warm audience is anybody that's watched any of the cold audience videos for 10 seconds or more, or anybody that's liked my Facebook page, anybody that's interacted with my Facebook page, anybody that has, which is why, by the way, we're doing these on Facebook Live, because we get to build up these videos there, we get to get all this data, and we get to get people interacting with us. If you visited my website in the last 180 days, you know, you're getting to put in these buckets. And then what happens is, when you get put into the warm bucket, which is what the second bucket's called, you start to get a lot of different content from me. Basically, every time I'm making these new videos, I'm just popping them in there, and I'm putting them out there to the world, okay? That way, you're gonna get consistent new content out to an audience that cares about you, and then you know they care about you because they've watched your video. And by the way, you may be like, oh, 10 seconds, that's no big deal. Do me a favor and set your timer for 10 seconds and start scrolling on Facebook, okay? And anytime you stop on something, start the timer and watch how many times you actually watch 10 seconds of anything. It's a long time in the world of the internet, in the world of our smartphones, and in the world of Facebook. It's a lot longer than you think. So when they get in this warm bucket, they start watching videos, okay? When anybody in that warm bucket watches 25% or more of any of those videos in that warm bucket, then we start hitting them with real life offers, okay? That's when we get a little jiggy with like, hey, do you want me to help you? If you do, please just click here and schedule a free strategy session, right? That's what I mean by offers. Like, we're getting to the point. Nitty gritty. No more helping. Now we're selling and we're going after them hard, right? Because that's because they've basically demonstrated that they're interested in what we have to say. Okay? That's it. That's the framework. Okay? Now, reminder. If it sounded cool, but it sounded like way over your head, remember, come and see me on April 5th in Kansas City. You know, this has been probably a 20-minute podcast. I'm going to take the whole day and break all this down. Okay? And I'm going to start you with the most important part of the whole thing, which is, what do you want to do first? Like, what's the end goal? Are you trying to get people to call you? Are you trying to get them to watch a video? Are you trying to get them to download a PDF? Like, what's the goal? That's where we start, and we back everything up from there. Okay, so hopefully this helped. I think I'm done for now. Oh, by the way, if you want to go check that out, it's q2workshop.com. q2workshop.com. Go check it out. You're going to learn a little bit more stuff. There's an informational video up there that sort of walks through this process again. You can't get enough. I can tell you too, by the way, what I've given you today is a framework that you can use to get success if you want. However, there are some nuances to this. That's why it takes a day. That's why I've spent a day at Frank Kern's office learning all about this. Because there are some strategies and some tactics that you can employ that can make this go faster, that can make this process have an even higher return on investment for you, but I can't just explain them here in like a 10-minute video. It just doesn't work like that, okay? And I want you to be committed to this process, put a little bit of your own money in the game to learn it, so that way you'll actually do it, because I guarantee you a lot of you here think and know this is a great strategy, but you're not gonna employ it because you're gonna come up with a bunch of excuses. So if you wanna break the excuse cycle, come to the event, right? q2workshop.com. And that is it, I think, for today. So hopefully you enjoyed this. You know, this is like, this is gold, okay? Literal gold. You can go make money with this right now. So go try it. Go try it a little bit and come and sign up, right? We're going to be doing, I can tell you, if you are a backroom member and you're listening to this and it's before February 28th, you need to go to your email or to the Backroom group page, Facebook page, and come and sign up because you're getting a deal. If you are not a Backroom member and you're listening to this after February 28th or before February 28th, I would also encourage you to go look at Q2Workshop.com as soon as possible because I have a series of bonuses that are expiring as time goes by, right? I want to fill this event up as quickly as possible so I don't have to worry about doing that anymore. I can just focus on putting on a good show and teaching amazing shit and helping you guys sort of get to where you want to go. So I'm trying to fill this thing up. And to do that, I'm giving you guys crazy, crazy deals, okay? Remember, what I want you to think about is, the question I think I would be asking, I always ask is, how long will it take me to get my investment back on this thing that I'm doing, okay? So let's say this thing costs $5,000, which it should. It doesn't, but it should. So let's say this thing costs $5,000. I would think to myself, okay, is what I'm gonna learn in this day-long workshop, that, by the way, I know is baller, do I believe it's gonna help me get two new clients, maybe three new clients that I would not have been able to get otherwise, that I would not have gotten otherwise, okay? If the answer is yes, that means I'm breaking even. That probably means I'm going, okay? Because I know if I can get one client with it, I can get another client and another client and another client. And I know that there's an upside to this investment in addition to the actual content, which is getting to hang out with cool law firm owners, right? Getting to hang out with cool people, getting to talk to me one-on-one, right? You know, get to ask questions and be in a Q&A and just hang out. I'm doing a sponsored happy hour afterwards. I'm buying the first $500 of drinks and appies for everybody that's in attendance so we can hang out and sort of just talk and get to know each other. And that'll be like one of the giveaways. So maybe that'll go away. We'll just do it for like 20, 15 people, 10 people. But anyway, see how this goes? Go check it out, Q2Workshop.com. Re-listen to this episode again. Go try some of this stuff. I think you'll be surprised at the response that you'll get. And hopefully it helps your firm, right? That's what this is all about. It's all about building your law firm. It's all about making dreams come true. Okay, that is it. I'll probably talk to you again soon. If you are not on my Facebook page, Building a Law Firm or CMS Law Firm, you're crazy because you can go see what I'm doing specifically there right now. So go do that. Okay? That's it. See ya.